Welcome back to the channel, folks. Welcome back to the channel, Boobiddle.
Oh, hey, man.
Doing a little homework over there, I see.
Oh, we're live.
We're live. We're doing a live, if your mic's on.
Yeah, I guess I just was informed that
sometimes
my mic was off in a recent video.
It happens from time to time. Yeah, we are professional, but semi-professional, I guess, is the best way to put it.
Okay.
But let's be professional.
What are we doing here?
Yeah, what are we doing here and who are we with? Why don't you say who we're with?
We're Franklin, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram.
And drop that info is on the screen. And what this thing's here. Brand new. The reason this man's doing homework is that this thing is brand new.
Yeah, it's brand new. I only at our most recent event a couple of days ago saw it for the first time.
Yeah.
It was probably this one. I just kind of saw it in passing, but people were piled around it, so I didn't even get to look at it. So
what is it?
All right, well,
tell us.
2021 Jeep Grand Cherokee L.
L, 4x4, limited.
Correct.
All those names.
Yeah, Cherokee L Limited 4x4. This has the option, this has the V6.
V6 could come with a V8.
There is an optional V8, but this has just, I think, under 300 horsepower.
And the L, folks, the L means it's longer. And
it is.
So it's got the third row. So we're going to do what we normally do and start in the rear of the vehicle.
Real quick, as we make our way, I know that it looks a little dirty, but...
It is a little dirty, but there is some legit sparkle in this paint, folks.
I don't know if y'all can see it. This thing...
It's got some sparkles.
It's going to bling.
Yeah. Really. And, we're in the shade because it's 100 and something degrees here in Middle Tennessee today. So we had to find a way to cool off. All right. So we're around back. It looks pretty much similar... This looks very similar to the Wagoneer, right?
Yeah.
It is.
I mean, this is kind of, it's a throwback kind of.
Well, they have the Wagoneer that just came out that's, the $120,000 version of this upscaled a little bit.
Oh, really?
So this is the one, first third row seat available in the Grand Cherokee.
Ooh.
Clearly, it's got electric roof or
hatch.
Fair amount of room back here. All the mats are still in here. This car is brand new, so everything is all piled in. I think Bobiddle just found himself a nice place where we could usually store a bag, and there's...
What do you think?
I don't know. All these weird little... There's something there, but we don't know. I bet you it's just like a panel to get to
jack
and stuff. That's kind of a nice...
A little funnel there.
Oh, so you're going a little drink in there, okay. Now let's see if Bobiddle can get that back closed. And he did. Perfect. All right, so here's your third row seats that... make this, that's really like the main reason this thing exists.
Yeah. I don't know why.
That's
for your...
to close it, right?
Oh,
no, hold the set how high.
Right, depending
this
on
goes.
How high your garage is. You can
really cool function. I love that they're thinking so far ahead now with stuff like that.
But I gotta wonder, Ben, at this point, wouldn't it make sense to have a button, a power fold? I don't know if that's an option, but...
So in the Wagoneer, I know it's a power fold, but you're gonna see this is pretty easily done from what I understand. If we grab that handle and pull that, there you go, and it's down. And it could be mechanical, but it is pretty easily done as you just noticed. Now we've presented ourselves with a ton more room to store your things.
I do like this. You got
two
USB-C
power jacks on either side as he's showing you there.
Nice. You know what? I think this is a nice rubber sort of armrest here in the cup holder, and I feel like that was probably
by design. For the kids, right?
Yeah, so easy cleanup, spilling drinks or such.
And if you, to bring these up, I'm pretty sure all he has to do, there it is. Just grab that, and then you just lift the headrest. So not too crazy. A lot of the other brands are making that mechanical, whether it's by spring load or actual electrical. I'm pretty sure if you just press that button, that is also your closing button, the hold to set. And I like how it gives you the extra moment there because it is inside. Bo, I think one of the reasons they moved it is for water. So much water was gathering in these areas here that it's kind of messing with the electrical. That's my CSI moment for the day. So it definitely
can. I just want to say, these tail lights, I really like this, how it really kind of wraps around.
It's a tail light and a side marker at the same time, folks. Because do they even have side markers on the front?
Mm. Okay. Weird. Well, are we going to get in this thing, Ben? And
we will. Do you want to do a little startup? Does it have the auto start on the key fob?
We're going to check it out, but it does. But I mean, it's got a pretty just base V6, so I don't know how exciting it'll be.
Dude, it's like nothing. It's actually kind of nice. It's pretty quiet.
It's quiet.
It really hit. How much power did you say the V6 has? Or this thing has?
270 or
some 290.
This thing's low on fuel.
Yeah. If you're wondering, folks, when you do that and it's low on fuel, it turns itself off. So once you go to the other side, hop in, press the unlock button for us. We'll show these folks these nice fancy wheels on here. Looks like they are 20s. That is my best guess. I am correct. They are 20s. So in this cabin, I do like these captain's chairs that are sitting in here. Really presents a ton of room. They come with the armrest, which is nice. Door cards, but if you talk about it up there too, like all this wood paneling, man, it looks legit. Really nice, honestly. Really, really nice. Nice stereo in here too. They have you said they have a couple options for stereos, right?
Yeah, there's a Alpine system that you can get, and then if you want to get real crazy with it, a 19 speaker Macintosh arrangement.
Oh, so like enough to blow your face off, basically. Before we get too far into the interior or the front of it, nice cup holders. I really like all this power area. Definitely has the AC control. All of this is really, it looks really good back here. And then this is all new up front, right? I guess this whole center stack and a lot of this stuff is all new.
Yeah, this is all different.
So take us through it. Show us what you got up there, my friend.
I mean, even the interface, all this looks different. But it's
really
looks pretty,
nice. Looks, you know, really nice. Nice waterfall kind of dash.
It looks pretty simple, though, to navigate. You know, sources, Bluetooth. I believe it does have Apple CarPlay and Android.
Yeah, I think it's Bluetooth Apple CarPlay too, which makes things whole lot easier. I know that's a new tech for a lot of these cars. I'm sure that this has it as well.
So this is simple. You got your phone right here, so you can add it. Like, so this looks like a pretty easy
interface, man. Yeah. Dodge is really good, and or Jeep, I guess, is the same brand. They're using the same kit on the inside.
We have a heated steering wheel, driver profiles.
And I think you can move those around at will as you desire.
What's the, wow, the fam cam.
Dude, that's, if y'all don't see that, that's us
that
inside.
That is incredible. How?
Okay. Deuces.
What kind of voodoo is this? Because I don't see it.
I've never seen it. I guess it's for those third rowers. It's really focusing.
Oh, it's back there on.
Yeah, it's in this little thing here for sure. Really
Dude,
cool.
That is so cool.
we just found that. That's so cool.
There's Alexa for some reason. That, I mean, that's,
yeah, that's right,
because awesome.
That's part of the Apple CarPlay.
Okay, yeah, that's true. Off-road pages.
This also has the, because this is a 4x4, it's got the off-road kit. I think it's a full-time all-wheel drive system, rather than like being crazy Jeep style, but very functional. These things are still, I don't know that it's trail rated, but they can get and take you and your family, I guess, a lot of places. He's loading the nav. While he's doing that, let's take a look at this center console.
Let's have a look. Looks like there's a couple levels here, a little shallow.
And then a big,
just,
deep one.
Yeah, nothing really in there. It's just, it's there.
Cavernous.
Yeah.
And then nice cup holders. I think, is that up area up there for a charging port area, or is there just kind of stick your cell phone in there kind of slots?
Yeah, I think just stick your cell phone in there slots. I don't see any kind of wireless charging symbols. I like this right here. If you can see, you got your drive modes here. So, and then when you do that, it does change.
Take the camera and show the folks.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's
see here. When you do press it.
Go to the, so we're in snow, sand, and mud.
That's cool how it shrinks down like that. And then
auto, and then sport. Oh, yeah. It kind of changes the flooring there.
Pretty cool. And once you go to pull away, your tach and speedometer will then grow back to large. Show these folks the vents and this crazy woodwork. Oh, yeah. There's some great angles.
One thing, well, it's not, you know, if you're sitting back here, it's not obvious, but you've got some controls up here. Your auto start and off, lane keeping assist, traction control, your parking sensors, emergency lights here. It looks like, depending on the model and trim packages, there's probably a couple more options. I don't know what those would be. But yeah, you got kind of these really kind of cool narrow vents right here. So I
and the way,
like that.
I love the shape, how the wood just kind of comes curving off the dash right there into, it just looks so cool
I'm
from
not
back here.
Generally in wood grain, but this is like a really dark kind of finish.
It looks nice,
dude. It looks really nice.
Show that steering wheel too, because I know that steering wheel's new for this year.
Yeah, this is a little bit different, isn't it?
It's got, I love the little aluminum bezel that kind of goes around the whole thing there, the whole center part.
Got your cruise control, such over here, making calls. I don't know what, let's see what that is.
Oh.
Okay, so that's going to bring up, looks like kind of your menu items, so you can kind of cycle through.
Get your, so that's cool. So now you know for sure that that's the, that whole thing is a screen. It kind of, now you really can tell.
And then you do have your paddles here, and then there are some button controls on the back for your volume on each side here.
Volume and then like next track or whatever.
And then let's see, we'll take a look over here. Just pretty basic lighting, emergency brake.
Really pretty, really nice. I mean, this is a Jeep, Bobiddle.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of the things that you, hop out here and you want to pop the hood.
You know, I gotta say, I have a feeling there's gonna be some really cool color combinations. I can imagine this with like a nice brown.
Yeah, they'll do it up. And before we exit, it does have the crazy huge pano roof, which is really nice. Again, these things are all coming to pano roof. And
LED lights throughout.
It's really bright too. It's honestly messed with our camera a little bit. But one of the things I've noticed with a lot of the higher end luxury vehicles is the extra vent that's been added here to give cooling to the back seat. Jeep has it, and it's awesome. It just kind of shows they're trying to be next level. Plenty of room as far as trying to get out of the vehicle there, folks. I'm a bigger gentleman. Sometimes it is hard to get out of these rear seats. That was simple. So nothing too exciting under here, just a V6. At some point, they will probably be throwing their hybrid motor at this thing. You said it does have a V8 option as well.
Yeah, it's like a 360 horsepower V8.
Oh, hammy.
And
throw
a
hammy in it.
A couple years down the line, we might see some pretty cool versions of this thing.
You're right. Well, not the one area we didn't take a crazy look at was this front grille. Definitely new shape, new LED or new headlights and daytime running lights.
I know there will probably be a package where it's
all blacked out.
It'd look really good.
It's going to look real good. And, you know, he's kind of referencing some of these chrome bits that you're seeing, these bezels. Yeah, this is the very first one of these we've seen. They had a white one and a black one. We chose the black because, I don't know, I just liked it a little bit better. But, well, that's about all we got for you guys. Again, we got this vehicle from who, Bobiddle?
Franklin Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
And their info is on the screen. Go to their website, hit them up for something like this or any of their products. He just named them all. Hit them up, go to their website. These guys have been big supporters of ours for a long time, really great people to work with. So I guess that's all we got. For my man Bobiddle, I am Ben Barber. We will see you guys in the next video.